you can win $32,000 on the turn of a card on Card Shark. And if you play your cards right, you can win this beautiful car. And now, the host of Card Shark, Bob Eubanks.
Thank you. Thank you. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Card Sharks. We're glad you could join us today because we have lots of money to give away and a beautiful new car to give away, too. Maybe it'll happen. And also, we have two very lovely dealers who are with us every day. We couldn't do it without them. I want you to meet them once again. And here they are, Lacey Pemberton and Susanna Williams. Oh, how pretty you look today, ladies. We have a brand new contestant arriving, so we'll start right with game number one. Okay, while the girls are setting up with the cards, let's meet our card sharks. Here they are, our champ and our challenger. Look at her smile.
Hello, Bob.
You ought to be so happy. You won $6,500 first day. How's that?
I'm so excited.
Tell us about Cindi, those two kids, and that husband.
Okay. My name is Cindi Listander. I married my high school sweetheart 8 years ago.
That works, doesn't it? My son did the same thing.
Did he really?
Yeah.
I have two children. Nikki's 5 and Eddie's 20 months, and I love to snow ski.
Well, that's wonderful. Nice to have you back with us.
Thank you.
You won $6,500 yesterday, and we have a new challenger for you. Bob, how are you today?
Just fine, Bob. How are you?
I'm just fine. What's your name?
Bob Eubanks. That's right. For years, Bob, people have been asking me.
Wait a minute. Stop. Your name is Bob what?
Bob Eubanks.
Your name is Bob Eubanks.
I am the real Bob Eubanks.
You're the real.
For years, people have been asking me.
Daddy! Daddy! Come here, Daddy!
No. Yeah.
My daddy! I think that's neat.
Yeah.
What do people say to you?
Oh, they come up to me all the time and say, are you the real Bob Eubanks? Bob Eubanks from the Newlyweds or Bob Eubanks from Car Sharks?
Yeah.
I said, no, but I am the real Bob Eubanks from Columbus, Ohio, and I'm here today just to make everybody believe me. All right.
Now, how do you spell your Eubanks?
Same way you spell yours.
Eubanks, isn't it?
Yes.
Right? I'll be darned.
That's right.
I've never had a relative on a show before. I'm so excited, I don't know what to do. That's wonderful. Nice to have you here.
Thank you.
Bob Eubanks. Ooh, does that sound weird?
Let me ask you a question,
yes,
Bob.
Yes, you ask me a question. Yes, sir.
Yes. Is your real name Bob Eubanks or just your stage name?
Do you think I would change my name to Bob Eubanks? If I was going to change my name, I'd call myself Bobby Barker or something like
okay.
that.
Okay.
No, Eubanks is my real name. Is that your real name?
That's my real name.
And Bob's your real name, too. Are you Robert?
Robert.
Robert, what's your middle name?
Alfonso.
Aha. It is there we part, my friend.
What's your middle name?
Alfonso is my middle name.
No. All right.
Okay, let's play this game. Ready to go? Got to win two games in order to win the championship. And first player to win two games goes on to play for the big money. Our first question of the day goes to Cindi, and this question involves 10 single women who are in our studio audience. Ladies, if you would, please. Now, welcome back with us, girls. Cindi, before the show, we asked these 10 single women, have you ever been to a show with male strippers? How many of these 10 women have been to a show with male strippers?
I have never been to a show with male strippers, but I'd sure like to go to one.
Would you really?
See. You bet.
Ugh.
I think that number is going to be a high number. I'll say 6.
6 of them, you say, have been to a show with male strippers. Bob, higher or lower than that?
Well, Bob, today I think that's more popular than would have been 10 years ago. And looking at these ladies, I would say that a few more of them than 6 have been to a male striptease show.
You think it's higher than that?
So I'd say it's higher.
Let's see. The actual number of these women who have been to a show with male strippers is 6 of them. Yeah. Whoa. Right on the button again, my friend. You did that yesterday.
Thank
and also, we're
going
to share $100 with our group down there. 6 of you have been to a show with male strippers. Which 6 of you have done that? Oh, there's Susan again. Yes. Susan, you've been everywhere, haven't you, huh?
I like to go all now, over. But
now, what's the most exciting thing about seeing some male stripper?
I didn't want to go, and I didn't like it, but it was exciting because my friend Sandy, it was her bridal shower. And she loved it.
That is real weird.
Well,
why didn't you want to go?
Well, I had to throw it. I didn't want to go because my brother told me that he wouldn't respect the fact that I did.
Let me give you a hint, Susan. It doesn't matter if your brother respects you the next morning. Believe me, it doesn't. Thank you, ladies. Okay, here we go. You ready, Cindy?
I'm ready.
Here's your first card. That card is a 3.
Higher!
Higher than the 3. It's a 7.
Freeze.
Freeze there. Okay, now she wants to freeze right there. We'll go on to our next question very quickly, and this one goes to you, Bob Eubanks. We surveyed 100 married men. We asked them, when your boss yells at you, do you take it out on your wife? How many married men admitted they do that?
Well, I was married, Bob, once, and I didn't do that. I never took the work back to home, at least not as much as I should have, maybe.
You just didn't go home, is that what you're telling me?
So I don't think many men would take it out on their wives. I think that would be a low number. I'd say around 45.
45 out of 100 married men admitted they do that. Cindy, higher or lower than that?
I know my husband gets very disgusted with me when his boss gets on him. I think that's going to be higher.
It's going to be higher. Wow. I hope not. The actual number of married men who take it out on their wife when their boss yells at them is 21. No, it wasn't higher. It was lower than that. Bob, now you have control. Okay, Bob, you know you can change this card. If you don't like it, it's a 4.
I like that card. Higher, Bob.
Higher than a 4? How about an ace?
Ooh, lower, Bob.
Lower than the ace. How about a 3?
Higher, Bob.
Higher than the 3. Look here.
Lower, Bob.
Gonna go on. Is it lower? No. And back to the 4, Bob. Ooh. Eubanks goes. And that means that Cindy gets a free shot off the 7.
Change that card.
No, you can't. You didn't win the high-low question.
Is it higher?
Higher. Let's see if it's higher than the 7. Yes.
Woo! Lower.
Lower than the queen. Yeah.
Higher.
All right. In order to win game number 1, will it be higher than the 4? It is. Okay. So the first game is yours. Another $100 added to your total. Cindy, we'll pause for these words. We'll be right back with more Card Sharks and these two nice contestants right after this. Welcome back to Card Sharks. Our champ just won game number 1. Bob, that means you've got to win this game in order to stay in the match. Lacey's got the cards all dealt out from the same decks, and here we go with our first question in game number 2. Cindy, the question is yours, and it involves our 10 single ladies in our studio audience. So, ladies, if you would, please get in position, and here we go. Takes those ladies a long time to get in position, doesn't it? Okay, Cindy, here's the question. Before the show, we ask our 10 single women, do you kiss on the first date? How many of these 10 women do kiss on the first date?
Boy, I know I did.
You did?
You bet. I think that's going to be a high number. These ladies look very kissable. I would say 8.
8 of them kiss on the first date. Bob.
Well, Bob, again, I think that we're living in a different age, and I think that just a few more have kissed on the first date, so I'm going to say higher.
You think it's higher than that?
Yes.
I tend to agree with you, Bob.
I hope so.
Actual number of these women who kiss on the first date is 6 of them. 6 of them. That means there's 4 liars among them, okay? All right, which are the loose girls that kiss on the first date? You girls, Melanie, you kiss every time on the first date?
Not every time.
No, I'm sorry, I was talking to Melody and Melody. That's okay. Melody, you kiss on the first date?
Not every time. It depends on the guy.
I do. How about you, Melanie?
It happens.
I should have stuck with you, Melody. I'm really sorry. Stay right where you are, girls, and don't move. What does she say? Do you know what she said?
Okay.
What's the? Oh, turn the card. Okay. There's an 8 for you. What are you gonna do, Cindy?
Change that card. Yeah.
8 becomes a 4.
Higher.
Higher than the 4. Look at there.
Lower.
Is it gonna be lower? It is.
Freeze
on the 9. Hey, she's only 2 cards away from winning the championship and a chance to win a lot of money. Well, that means that, Bob, the pressure's on you, and we're going to go right back to those 10 girls, I hope. Now, be careful, ladies. Before the show, we asked these 10 single women, would you marry a millionaire who demanded that you sign an agreement stating that you could never get alimony. How many of these 10 women would marry the millionaire even if they could never get alimony?
That's a tough question, Bob. Although, I think I would marry a millionaire just because I think I'd stay married to that person and live high anyway. I would think out of the 10 ladies we have here that 4 of them would marry a millionaire even if they couldn't get alimony.
Even if they couldn't get alimony, huh?
Yes.
I disagree.
Cindi, what do you think about this?
I would never sign anything like that. I think it's going to be lower.
Why wouldn't you sign something?
I'm entitled to alimony if I married him.
If he's a millionaire before he married you, you want everything he's earned from the time he grew up. Is that it?
Lower, Bob.
Lower, I see. Actual number of these 10 women who would marry the millionaire, even if they could never get alimony, is 2 of them. You're right. It was lower. Don't tell me. Which two would do that? I'm telling you about Susan. She wants to move out of her parents' house so bad that she will just do anything. Ladies, thank you very much for being with us today. All right, here we go. Cindi.
Okay, Bob, change that card.
Let's change it. 9 becomes a 5.
Higher.
Higher than the 5? No, not higher than the 5. Bob, you get a chance at the cards, and you better do some catching up, my friend. You can't change it. Got to play it. It's a deuce.
Higher, Bob.
Higher than the deuce. There's a 6.
Higher, Bob.
Higher than the 6. There's a 7.
Higher, Bob.
What's going on? Is it higher than a 7? No, it is not. And back to the deuce he goes. And that's where we are as of right now. We'll pause with these words and continue with game number 2 when we come back right after this. Welcome back to Card Sharks, and we're ready now to continue with this game. If Cindi wins this game, she's the champ. Bob, you got to keep that from happening. Here's question number 3, and this is one of our educated guess questions. Cindi, it goes to you. How many miles long is the Berlin Wall? Boy, there's a question for you. How many miles long is the Berlin Wall? You never think about it, but it's an interesting question.
Bob, I don't even know about the Berlin Wall, but I'm going to say 300 miles.
300 miles. Okay. Bob, what do you think about this one?
Well, Bob, I don't
know. Oh, it can't be? Oh, it can't be over 99. Yeah. It can't be over 99. So you missed it by just a touch. So
just a touch.
Yeah. Let's try it again. How many miles long is the Berlin Wall? It can't be over 99.
75.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
75. Now, Bob.
Well, Bob, I don't think there's a city that's 75 miles wide. So I'll say a little lower.
A little lower now.
Yeah.
Well, we Bob Eubanks are smart, aren't we?
We don't know
the
yet.
The actual length in miles of the Berlin Wall is 26. 26 miles. Okay, Bob, you have control now. And the deuce is yours. I know you want to keep
it. Higher car, Bob.
Yeah, higher than the deuce. There's an 8.
I got to go higher, Bob.
He's going to go on. Higher than the 8. No, not higher than the 8. Back to the deuce he goes. And Cindi, you get a free shot from the 5.
Higher.
Higher than the 5. King.
Lower.
Okay, this is for the championship. If it's lower than the king, it is. You've done it again, kid. Congratulations to you.
Thank you.
Championship round. That means you get to play for the big money, maybe win the car, too. Bob, I've never met another Bob Eubanks, and I'm very excited about that, and it's really nice having you with us. Thank you very much. We have
really
a nice
enjoyed myself, Bob.
So you're the real Bob Eubanks.
Yeah.
Okay, pal. Nice to see you. Okay, Cindi, come here, champ. You've done it again. Good for you. Now, you won the championship. That was a good match. Now you have a chance to win all that money again and also a chance to win the car. So here comes Lacey and Susanna, and they're ready to deal out the big money cards from a deck that you cut before we went on the air. Now you know how to play the big money cards. In addition to all the money you can win, as you know, we've added a couple of jokers to the deck, and anytime one of them turns up in the money cards, well, you'll have a chance at winning this Chevrolet Sprint that is right over there. And for winning the match, we're going to give you an extra joker, which will guarantee you a chance at the car. So you at least have one chance of winning the car. So if you're ready, give the lady $200, and we are on our way. Good luck to you. Here we go, Cindi. First card is a 4, and you've got $200.
$150
higher. $150
higher
than the 4. There's a jack. Now you got $350.
$300 lower.
$300 lower than the jack. It's a 10. Yes, now you got $650.
$500 lower.
Gonna keep the 10 then. Yeah. Okay, $500 lower. $500? $500 lower than the 10. Yeah. How dare I doubt you, huh?
Change that card.
$11.50. I'll give you another $400. It gives you $15.50.
Change that card.
Which one you want?
Number one.
Number one, okay. Rules say you can change the card one time per line. The nine now becomes a seven. You gotta play. $15.50.
$50 higher.
$50. Gonna play it real conservative. Okay, $50 higher than the seven. It's a queen. Yes. $1,600. $1,400 lower than the queen. There's a six for you. $3,000.
$2,000 higher.
$2,000. Boy, the lady wants to come. Whew, you make me very nervous. $2,000 higher than the six. Big bet. Will it be there? No. That brings you down to $1,000. That's all right. You've got a deuce
okay.
up here, and you can still win $2,000.
All of it higher.
All of it higher than the deuce. There's a queen, and now you get another $2,000. All right. Wow. You're a gutsy lady. You know that. Okay. That means you have $8,800. We're going to pause for these words and be right back and give you a chance to win the car right after this. Welcome back to Card Sharks. Well, champ. You got a couple $1,000 a year. That was a pretty gutsy bet. Wow.
I said I was going to go for it.
Boy, you did. But that's, you got another $2,000. You're doing real well. And no jokers came up over there, but you know you won one joker for winning the match. So that joker is yours. That means you have one chance to win this beautiful car. Take a look, Cindy.
The Chevrolet Sprint, two-door hatchback coupe with 1.0-liter L3 engine, five-speed manual transmission, and California emission. Okay, Bob.
Okay, Cindy, that's the car you can win. We want to wish you all the luck in the world. Here's how you do it. Over there, you'll see seven numbered cars. Behind one of them is the word car. If you find the car, well, it's yours. So you tell us, where do you want to place the joker? This time, it's number three. Good luck to you. I hope it's there. Let's find out. Is it going to be there? If the word car is behind number three, this lady wins that new car. Come on, Cindy, be there. Oh, no. Where was it? Oh, couple over. No, it was way down at the end. They tell me the car was right there. That's okay. You're going to have a chance to do it again if you remain our champion, and we're going to give you a chance to do that right now. Your earnings so far are $8,800. And if you are ready,
I'm ready.
You are. Well, then I want you to go right over there where the champion stands and let's meet our new challenger. Come on, Payday. How are you doing?
Fine. Just great, as a matter of fact.
I can't help from noticing your name. Payday. You've come to the right place.
You betcha. Well, it turns out I was born on my father's payday and the name stuck and he nicknamed me Payday and I'm just happy to be here.
He nicknamed you Payday. What's your real first name?
Gene.
Gene. So, but you've been Payday all your life then?
35 years.
Is that all your life? Not yet.
So far.
Okay. Tell us about yourself.
Again, I live here in Canoga Park, and I'm a salesman. I sell video and stereo, and I've been here now 19 years.
Good. Well, it's nice to have you with us. You know how to play the game.
Yes, of course.
Okay, the lady's pretty tough that you're standing next to, and we're dealing out the cards right now. Lacey will deal out the cards in the decks you cut. First player to win two games wins the championship, and we are on our way. And here we go with our first question. Cindy, this one's yours. Surveyed 100 married men. We asked them, did you marry your high school sweetheart? How many married men said they did? You did that, didn't you?
I married my high school sweetheart, but I don't think many do. I think a lot of people have relationships in high school, but for one reason or another, they fall through. I think that's going to be a low number. I'll say 38.
38 out of 100 married men said they married their high school sweetheart. What do you think, Payday?
Oh, it's got to be lower than that. I mean, after high school, you've got college, and there's so many more relationships. Much lower, Bob.
I think it's going to be lower. Actual
lower.
Number of married men who married their high school sweetheart is 13. You're right. It was much lower.
Right.
You bet. All right, Payday, welcome to our show. Here's your first card. Deuce
is
yours.
Higher, Bob. Definitely higher.
Is it higher? Yeah, it is.
Lower.
How about lower?
You bet. Higher.
Look at here.
I'm going to freeze.
Thought sure he's going to run the cards, but he freezes on the nine, one card away, winning game number one. Why don't we pause? We'll be back with more Card Sharks right after this. Welcome back to Card Sharks. All the time we have for today. Hate to pause right here where Payday was about to win the first game and you were getting real nervous over there. But you won $8,800. I know you'll be back next time. Payday will be back. Also want to remind everybody that we have Kids Week coming up in just a couple of weeks from now. So we'll tell you a little bit about that tomorrow. All right? Until next time, I'm Bob Eubanks for Susanna Williams, Lacey Pemberton, Gene Wood, and the whole gang saying thank you very much for watching Card Sharks. We really appreciate it. So long, everybody. See you then. Bye-bye.